I would actually congratulate the Minister of Finance for taking up this issue, but I'd be happier if he, given the circumstances in India today, had a discussion instead of this scheme, if he had the discussion on the economic situation in India and the slowdown in India. Because India is probably going through one of its most difficult phases in the economy. And I just remember this morning also in his reply, the Honorable Finance Minister quoted a few, some of the data which was actually alarming. He said that the GDP is doing well, it's 15-year low. The unemployment is 45-year low. The household consumption is 4 decades low. The bad loans are at all-time high. And the growth, I'll give an example in like electricity, is a 15-year low. So actually, India is probably going through the biggest distress in economy in decades. So I'm not even sure if really these schemes are going to last, because the biggest pressure today in India's economy is in rural India. And the consumer spending has fallen for decades, and especially more in the rural India. And I think the data speaks for itself. And I think somebody from the Honorable, I mean not the Honorable Finance Minister, but somebody from the government who's very learned, said that keep numbers away, just keep going, because numbers don't mean anything. And I would today like to quote late Sushma Ji, and I still remember her, she was the leader of opposition. I can never forget that speech. We were in power, inflation was high the way it is today, and we were talking about poverty. And I still remember her saying, it's something that still echoes in my heart and my ears. She said, "Aakdon se pet nahi bharta, jab bhook lagti hai na, tab dhan lagta hai." So I would take this opportunity to remind this government that this is not just about numbers and Ponzi schemes. I think what they really need to focus right now is put the economy on track by taking thoughts and ideas from people. And this whole thing about scams, how are we going to regulate it? I mean, Mehtab Ji has at length talked about all these schemes. What are chit funds? What are Ponzi schemes? These are all schemes poor people from various bottom of the pyramid put together, whatever little resources they have, eventually for their kids' education, for their retirement, or for their own insurance. Now, there was a very good recommendation done by the earlier finance committee saying, why don't you get these insured? So has this government thought about insurance? I mean, I see a lot of gap. It's a good recommendation on paper, but crop insurance again hasn't done very well. And as a matter of fact, the Shiv Sena had the biggest long march in Maharashtra against, when they were a part of this government, about insurance for crop schemes. So there is a very good suggestion. The intent is very good, but how are they going to implement it? Mehtab Ji suggested about the district, which was a great visibility. But chit funds are not necessarily a district. I was just thinking while he was speaking that in my constituency, at a village level, women get together and put this kind of money together. How are we going to regulate it? Even if the states had to regulate it, are the people who are regulating it, are they trained for it? So the government has a plan to regulate, and I think more than just regulations, we make regulations all the time. The Honorable Finance Minister many times has talked, I mean even today they talked about how low the inflation is. Well, the CAD sounds very good on paper, but that is only good because the oil prices are so low. There is no other reason why they are making these magic numbers. And the tax collection of this country, the tax collection is bottom low, it's 6,00,000 crores, which, and GST. So my whole point in this is, I'm actually very, very concerned that I'm not doubting the intent of this government. I'm sure they are going to do, they are trying to stop these schemes, but I don't see it really happening anywhere, especially when all of us who are all the time on the field. Has Ponzi schemes stopped? They haven't. Are there any stop it? And they keep saying Jandan Yojana. If they've done so well, probably tomorrow chit funds will not even exist. We may not need them if Jandan is run so well. So what, I mean, I'm actually confused about this. I'm not a finance expert. But from where I'm standing, who are these people who, these are all our voters, who sweet, simple people from villages, just collect money, put it together and think that if they get a little money more for their children's education, marriage and their social, you know, for their housing. So I would like to ask him to clarify as how they are going to do all this. They talked about economic offenders bill. This is a part of that. These are economic offenders, whether it's for a 1 lakh or a 15 lakh. Now in this bill I would like, how much money has really come back to this country? How many offenders are really punished? And they keep talk about redressal system. If tomorrow somebody had to reach out and was cheated, who do they turn to? It's like the bank cooperative bank in Mumbai, the PNB bank. People had to get on streets, they had to use social media. So where is the redressal system if there is a problem? So I think what we really need to address is, and it's not about your government versus our government, any government. And I appreciate Mr. Shetty's speeches, what he says, I really appreciate. He says what happened 5 years, they couldn't have, he talked about autonomy, and I think autonomy is the biggest thing. I was actually troubled when he said that even an MP is not, doesn't have autonomy. I think this is something far more serious outside the bandwidth of what he said. I mean, we live in a democracy. If we in this room feel that we are not autonomous, then I think which way is this country going? I think, and we are talking about autonomy in education, autonomy to people, to work, to think, to create, to innovate. So which way are we headed as a country if a learned member is feeling like that, who comes from one of the financial districts, which is the most important city in India, called Mumbai, if he feels so trapped, and it's not about him versus us, I'm talking about society at large. So I think we really need to put our minds together and talk about autonomy in a way where it's freedom of speech, freedom of, about RBI. I mean, if RBI is not autonomous, we took great pride in saying that it was an autonomous body which had an opinion. So if today, if even we feel that the RBI is not autonomous, my God, I think this is a national crisis if you ask me. So I think these are a lot of issues, and I, just out of my curiosity, because I am not a finance expert, is how much time or money do we engage in people in financial literacy? Probably zero. They don't know, they have no access. So is there, with so much technology, you are talking about video conferencing. It's a very, very good suggestion. But the way normally today, nowadays, the calls are dropping, how will we do video conferencing? And as a matter of fact, just 2 days ago, I think most of these companies, telephone companies, are almost saying they're bankrupt. So how are we going to video conference? Where will this person go to a collector's office? I don't know where the bandwidth is. So, I mean, the solutions look wonderful on the table. Your intent may be very, very good. I'm not doubting your intention at all. But it has to be implemented on paper and into a reality, because we are protecting the poor of this country. So I think it's not about us versus you, but let's put our mind in really saving, putting systems in place which are doable. If you ask Mumbai or Maharashtra police to look into financial matters, they are not even equipped to do it. So how are we going to do it even at a district level? Is my collector is already overworked. Talk about a Disha committee, it goes on for 5 hours. Kya? No, but I'm just asking questions. I'm actually asking questions. So, Disha committee ne bhi chitwan ka baat.
Aap mujhe address kijiye.
So I'm just asking is, how are we going to do it? How are we going to regulate it? And what is the system? If I'm a woman who is trapped in this at a chitwan, at a village level, who do I turn to? Do I go to the tahsildar? Who do I go to? I have no idea. So would you put in a system where it's really, because these are not all literate people. I think we really need to do a literacy program, not about reading and writing, but financial literacy. And you need to make sure that every chit fund which comes in, either he may be on a website, but where is this woman going to go and look at a website? So I think we need to do more thinking. Your intent is very good. We will support this intervention, but I don't think it completes the loop. I don't think it's going to solve any of our problems in a big way, because these financial frauds just still completely continue to keep going. And I would like to just ask one more question, last question before I sit down. You talk about the, yes, I have two suggestions. There is an insolvency code the Honorable Finance Minister talked about in his morning reply, which I appreciate. It's a very good intention. But really, how much collection has happened? And if I remember right, the RBI has said that this particular insolvency code is not a long-term solution. So if you are using this for financial frauds and the RBI has a view, then what is the Finance Ministry's view? So I think we really need to put, it's a very, very serious bill. We are happy to pass it, but I think the Finance Ministry, which is in the news for all the reasons which is putting the common man into panic, there are comments about the millennials using the Ubers. So I am really concerned, because people are losing jobs, and I think that's what this whole debate in this parliament first should be. The economy of this country, if you read The Hindu today, Dr. Manmohan Singh has written a wonderful article and made some very good suggestions. So I think some of the suggestions, so if you read some of the suggestions, it will help. But I think financial literacy from top to bottom is a must today. I'm not sure even the chair and me are so financially qualified. So I think it's not just that education, if we could include financial education within our education system, I think maybe it will help more people. Thank you.